Pandey and Professor Nayak for giving us this opportunity of interacting with very, very learned people that I saw. And like Professor Pandey was introducing each one of you, I could see that you are a very learned elite group of people imparting education to the society, which is a very, very noble cause. So I am very pleased that I will be spending next hour and a half with August company of very learned people, and I would be able to learn something from each one of you, so that we continue to contribute to the society in whatever way we can. So friends, I was being introduced, I have been with Bajaj Capital for 36 years. Bajaj Capital was started in 1965 by our founder chairman, Mr. K.K. Bajaj, who is still very active, and he comes to office every day. Of course, now it's lockdown, but even he's waiting now the lockdown to be completely lifted so that he can start coming to office. He's in his mid-80s now. In last 55 years, Bajaj Capital has been serving millions of clients across country. As it was mentioned, we have 235 offices now, almost in every state, and about 4,000 advisors are taking care of our clients' financial goals, etc. So I have rich experience of talking on the financial well-being matters. But over the years, we realized that financial well-being is just one part of a person's overall needs or a personality or why a person exists. So we then thought of expanding our horizons and moving beyond money matters. That is how we came up with this concept of from financial well-being to total well-being. So now we are doing research on various facets of our life, which are important to make our life very, very unique, very successful, and full of purpose. So that is the whole idea of sharing today with you about 10 pillars of Omni Life. So we call it Omni Life, as all of you would understand. Omni Life means a life lived well, a life lived king size, a life lived with purpose, a life lived with vitality, a life lived with energy, and a life lived longer. So I'm sure all of us have strong desire to live longer, but there always be attached some conditions to it, that there is no point living longer if our health is not accompanying us, or if we run short of money, then of course there is no point living, etc., etc. But that is what the entire topic today is, that how we can make our this one unique beautiful life that God has given us, making it an omni life, making it a completely full of purpose and full of quality, so that other people can emulate it and always exemplify us, that look, if somebody has to live, he has to live like this. Jindagi jindadili ka naam hai. So a lot of people live, but few people live with style, and few people live with such good health, and they radiate so much energy even when they are 80 or 90, that people actually want to know more about it, that what are these special self-care protocols which these people are following, that even at the age of 80 he looks to be 60, or even at the age of 90 he looks to be as energetic as 65 or 70. So we had great interest in this area, that we have been taking care of financial well-being. Let's move to total well-being. And our chairman, which is Mr. Bajaj's elder son, Mr. Rajiv Bajaj, this is his brainchild, the Omni Life. And about 5-6 years ago, he started doing global research on total well-being, as to what all facets we need to take care of our clients, apart from money matters, so that our clients live longer, our clients live a good life, and they are able to enjoy the money which we are giving them advice on how to grow their money, how to create wealth, etc., etc. So his research took him to several parts of the world. Is there any, all of you can hear me? Just raise your hand. Okay, thank you. So there are some blue zones in the world. Blue zones are such areas or such localities where the average longevity is much higher than the global average. So for example, in India also, I'm sure all of you would be knowing that as per the census estimates, the average longevity age in India is 73. When we got our independence, at that time it was in mid-50s, and now it has improved to about 72, 73, but it is still much lower than what has been attained in countries like Japan or in Singapore, etc., where it is 82, 83. So he did his research, And some blue zones have been identified like Loma Linda in California or Okinawa in Japan. And then there are a couple of islands in Greece. And so like that, there are five or seven such localities where the number of centurions is much larger than the rest of the globe. So a lot of people live there even up to the age of 90, 95, 100, 105, 110. And so a lot of research has been done as to what all these people do, what do they eat, how do they live, what are the special qualities which they imbibe so that they are able to live longer, and not only live longer, but they seem to be very happy, very active. So that is what brought us to the 10 pillars of OmniLife, which we would be discussing with you. So now, just to get the ball rolling, first of all, I would ask a little controversial question, and I'm sure, like we decided in the beginning, that you will interact through the chat. How many of us want to live up to 100 years? And if some of us, I'm sure some of us will say, well, what will we do living up to 100 years? What's the point? But yes, most of us, Dr. Gupta is saying most of us. Okay, but let me get some more responses that if we have to live up to 100 years, if we want to be a centurion, then what are our views on this? And if we are apprehensive about anything, what are those apprehensions that we may not live up to 100 years? Let me get some more responses. I'll wait. I know people will get a little bit time to get typing. Okay, it is healthy life beyond 100 is also okay. If it is healthy, everybody provided we are healthy. Healthy, okay. Health beyond financial insecurity. Yes, Dr. Surbhi is saying, yes, all of us want to live 100. Excellent. That is a... I feel, you know, we are in a very, very energetic group, that we are very optimistic that we all can live up to 100. But the two answers which I get as caveats were, yes, would like to, okay. The caveats were health and money. So I'm sure you would have heard these simple statements that I want to be on my 2 feet till I live. Yes or no? Tange chalti rehni chahiye. This is a common statement we make. And we hear from our elders, from our seniors, from our old relatives, if we are on our wheelchair or bed pe baithe hain last 10-15 years, you know, we are bedridden and there is a nurse attending to us. There is no point, no benefit of such a life. So I'm sure all of us want to live longer, but we want to be on our 2 feet till the last date. So yes, age is a number, if healthy. Yes, agree. So what we say now is that 80 is new 60 now and 100 is new 80. This is the definitions are changing now. Definitions are changing and all of us can very, very optimistically, very confidently plan and actually live longer and the way we wish to, which is on our 2 feet and with complete, in good mental health conditions and with good financial stability. That is what this entire session is all about. So I got almost, I would say, 100% positive response that yes, we all want to live up to 100 years, provided our health remains good and we do not run out of money. These are the two major apprehensions that many of us have, that our health will not support us. We will become dependent on our children for money or for health related matters, etc., etc. So now, if we were to live up to 100 years, what are the various aspects of our life that we need to pay attention to? This is where the 10 pillars will come from. And let me tell you in advance that all these 10 pillars, the answers are already known to each one of you, each one of us. There's no magic which I can share here. I'm sure you know this and you are not even expecting, you know, anything like that. But the discussions, the interaction with each other will make us much more clearer as to what little small steps we need to take in order to make this life an omni life, in order to make this life a fulfilling life, a life full of purpose, satisfactory, full of vitality and full of energy. So now let me get some answers as to what all are the areas or the different facets of our life on which we need to pay attention if we were to live an omni life. What are these 10 pillars that we are talking about? Let me get some answers. That we want to lead a good life, life full of purpose, purposeful, active life. Food, health comes first. Anchal is saying good health. Professor Pandey is saying yes, good health. Yes, fitness. Dr. Manisha is saying fitness. Social network, excellent, Professor Pandey. Social network is a wonderful thought in order to live longer. health and finance, Preeti is saying, okay, health and financial security, Dr. Ankit Goyal is saying, mental and physical health is required. Positive attitude, again, money required to lead these things, excellent. I feel happy, life and financial security, health and fitness, right. So emotional wisdom, harmony within yourself, excellent, Anchan Mishra. I think you came out with a very beautiful sentence, harmony with oneself. Beautiful, that is a very good thought. So we can see that how evolved all of us are, and growing more also matters. Yes, growing, you know, in terms of our knowledge, in terms of our maturity, in terms of our self-awareness, etc. So improvement, Manvi Jindal is saying, yes, improvement is required, but improvement in which areas? That is the question. What are those 10 areas in which we need to pay attention? Sustainable living. Professor Pandey is saying, yes, sustainable living. Sustainable is a word which is very much in vogue these days. Everywhere we talk about sustainable business models, etc., etc. Yes, it has to be sustainable. So I think we got relationship with society and nature. Anchal, I believe you probably are doing a lot of reading and you are already evolved because your answers are very, very unique and very, very correct. So again, I'm feeling very happy that all of us are thinking the same line. Satisfaction is what we are doing. Yes. Satisfaction, confidence in what we are doing. We should be passionate what we are doing. We should know what we are good at. And then if we do what we are good at, then we become passionate about it. Results are always good. Flexibility. Aditya Gupta is saying flexibility. Again, we are talking about, you know, our own, the way we deal with everyone, ecosystem, etc. So yes, flexibility is also very important when it comes to improving the quality of our life. So I think we got plenty of good answers. Interaction with everyone around us. Yes, Gaurav is emotional well-being. Yes, Professor Pandey, your answers are 2-3 words, but carry the weight of 1,000 words. Excellent. Adaptability, flexibility. Yes, so we got some beautiful, nice answers. Willpower. Neeraj Rai is saying willpower. Yes. These are all correct answers. But now, let us try and assimilate all these thoughts into the 10 pillars that we have classified. And then we will see that most of the answers which you have given are correct answers. And they will fit in one or the other pillar that we will talk about. And friends, the idea of this today's session, I did a similar session day before yesterday with the similar set of professors and teachers from Delhi College of Arts and Commerce. So, you know, that was a wonderful session. And there also we had a similar experience that we will come out with self-care protocols to which we will share with each other. And we will pick up some good ideas from each other and we will imbibe them in our own personality so that we can make our own life much more useful and full of life. So the way, how we say it is that it's not important to add ears to your life. It's more important to add life to your ears. So we are not only talking about up to 90 or 100. We're talking about living with purpose, living with the contribution to society, living with good mental health, living with good active health, etc., etc. So coming back to the 10 pillars, now we'll start covering one by one, each one of them. And here, before I start our journey of 10 pillars, I would also like to remind all of us that I'm sure all of you know this, the principle of Gestalt. The principle of Gestalt is, as you know, is the total is sum total is greater than the total of the sum parts of it. Which means that these 10 pillars that we'll talk about, if we individually do 3, 4, 5 of them, it will not give us the results. All 10 of them put together will give us much greater results. So because out of these 10 pillars, you already may be very good at 5 or 6 pillars, but still the results are not being yielded. We are not achieving what our goal is, which is to lead an omni life. So it's important to understand each of these 10 pillars, see which is getting in a neglected, where we are slightly weak, where we need to pay attention, and what are the self-care protocols that we need to bring into our daily life. Friends, self-care protocols are small steps, but much bigger impact. That is the whole idea. Choti-choti baatein, which we will discuss and we will learn from you also. We'll start with food. Number one, and of course the most important, and everyone can, you know, give that answer, that if we have this strong desire and ambition to live a good life and live a longer life and live a life that our family can be proud of, our society can be proud of, we have to make certain changes to our food habits. because it all starts from the gut. If our gut is in good health, our brain will be in good health, our heart will be in good health, and that is what will keep us active. So everything starts from the digestion in the gut. And then all the lifestyle diseases that we see in our society, they emanate, they get manifested only when we neglect these small things when it comes to food. So when it comes to food, we need to make certain choices. We need to make certain changes the way we consume our food. What kind of food? When should we eat it, etc., etc. So I will begin by small, simple things. And then I would also expect all of you to also share what are your views about some particular foods. Okay, when it comes to food, I'll begin with water. And before I start talking about water, let me also share with you one thing which I forgot to mention in the beginning itself, is that most of the things that we'll be sharing here today is out of ancient wisdom. It's not from the Western science. We are not quoting it. We are Indians, right? We have a strong culture. We feel proud of our culture. We feel proud of Ayurveda, which is 5,000 year old, medical science. And even in this COVID times also, even in this lockdown period also, I'm sure even our Prime Minister is also talking that Ayurveda has answers to many of these problems. When it comes to fighting the infection, or when it comes to keeping our spirits up, or when it comes to keeping our morale high. So Ayurveda has the answers to all of this. So we'll be quoting a lot from the Ayurveda and from the ancient wisdom, which is, like Dadi Ma Ke Nuske, what our Dadi used to tell us, or what our parents tell us, or what our Buaji used to tell us, etc., etc. So there will be a lot of quotations from what we have heard from our elders. So starting from water, and I'm sure most of you will find this basic stuff, but even if few people, start acting upon it, I think our job will be done. When it comes to water, as per Ayurveda, water always must be consumed at room temperature, always at room temperature, and which means slightly warm or gungana, or particularly in summers, we can take it directly from the RO, but never refrigerated, because the refrigerated water plays havoc with the digestion. And then that leads to the lifestyle diseases, not immediately, but maybe 5, 8, 10, 15 years into diabetes and BP and kidney related issues. So when it comes to water, simple changes that we need to make is that we need to drink about 8 to 10 glasses of water, that everybody knows. The other thing is that when it comes to food, water must be chewed and food must be drunk. Again, this is something which our parents have also told us. Our Dadi Dada have also told us. कि बेटे खाना चबा चबा के खाओ और पानी को ऐसे लो कि जैसे खाना है, which means that like I am also having this glass of water with me, I am keeping it here, I am sipping it every 10-15 minutes. Instead of drinking the whole glass of water at one go, as per Ayurveda, if you are having slightly warm water, not very warm, slightly warm water, room temperature water, start with one or two glasses in the morning. And during the day, if you keep sipping it regularly, your overall digestion would improve, which will result in excellent digestion, detoxification of your body, which will reflect in the glow on your face, and which will reflect in the energy levels and in the vitality and the ojas. And you will find yourself very active and very lightweight, and your productivity will go up multifold. Just this small change of avoiding refrigerated water completely and sticking to slightly warm water. This is as far as water is concerned. The other thing about water is that there should be a gap of at least 45 minutes between the meal and the water. So, and this is something which all of us know, because it comes in WhatsApp almost every day, that we need to observe these small self-care protocols. So this is as far as the water is concerned. The other thing about water and food also is that we should, as far as possible, we should consume it sitting down and not standing up. Of course, when we go on weddings or on some functions and all, there is no choice there. We have to consume water or eat food while standing. But as far as possible, from digestion point of view, it's important that we consume it while sitting. And when it comes to food, I'm sure all of you would agree that our ancestors have told us, ki bete 32 bari chabao, chew your food at least 32 times. And which means eat slowly. So the moment you start increasing, your chewing count, maybe you chew it 20 times, you increase it to 24, 28. If you can do it 32, very good. What will happen is that your food would melt, it would almost become liquid. And then the internal organs will not have to do any extra exercise of digesting it. And that itself, this one step itself would improve your health. It would help you reduce your weight, and it will help you, fat melting, etc. And then it will add to the overall vigor and energy. So increasing, chewing count and drinking water slowly. These are the two things as far as food and water are concerned. The other thing about food is that there should be a gap of 4 hours between the two main meals. And now if I were to take some suggestions from you, what are your good self-care protocols as far as food is concerned, which you follow and which you believe that would go in a long way in improving everybody's health and add few years to life? For example, even changing this habit of water to slightly warm water, etc., can add 4 to 5 years of our life. This is what Ayurveda they tell us. So let me get some answers from you about food. What all changes we can do when it comes to consumption of food? What kind of food we should eat? What kind of food we should avoid? Always have fresh food, not stale food. Excellent, Dr. Smita Agarwal. Yes, I'll give my views on that, of course, but these are correct views. Fresh food, mostly veg food. Yes, veg food. Eat within limit, right? Excellent. Take your last meal at least 4 hours before going to bed. Yes, Nikhil. Bang on. Balanced food, less consumption of oil. Dr. Mayank is saying. Avoid too much fat. Yes. Having dinner between 7 to 8. Daily, okay, pills. Okay, pills. But Vijay is saying he was taking pills, but he stopped taking it now because he's changed his food habits. Excellent. Less quantity. Right. So we got wonderful answers. Yes, we can. Less than required. Fresh, non-refined. Okay. So now I'll give you what our research has told us about eat half of what you wish to consume. Okay, half is little tough. It's not so easy just to stop at half. But the OmniLife principles about food are stop at 80%. This is what Japanese also follow, that they eat only 80% of their appetite. And after doing this practice for a few days, for a couple of months, then your body clock will start acting it properly and it will start reminding you that, look, you're 80% full. And stop eating now. And that is what will keep you very light on your feet. Also, taking a small plate, in which you normally take your food. If you shift to, instead of a big plate, you shift to a small plate. Small plate would mean smaller portions. That itself would be, a good reminder that we have to eat less. Yes, Jain philosophy is very good for in food matter. Vegetarian food is definitely preferred to non-veg food. But if some of us are used to taking non-veg food, there. Our OmniLife research tells us that we should stick to leaner meats like chicken and fish as compared to, red meat, which is like goat meat, etc., or some other meats that should be avoided. So, and also 3 servings of fresh fruits and fresh vegetables every day. 3 servings of fresh fruits and fresh vegetables every day. And like somebody said in the beginning, Ayurveda says we must consume our food within 2 to 3 hours after cooking and never eat overnight food. Some of us are into the habit of cooking big quantities, putting it into the refrigerator and then using it for next 3-4 days, which is actually not at all good for our digestion system and for our health. And that, as I said, if continued for a long time, can lead to some inside problems like hypertension or diabetes, etc. So yes, consume roughest fiber. So we know all these good self-care protocols. So when it comes to food, I would just like to share one more self-care protocol here. We all love South Indian foods, right? We all love South Indian food. We may not be cooking it at our home, but we often like to go to Sagar Ratna or Navedyam. Aajkal to COVID time mein hum nahi ja pa rahe hain bahar, but we miss it. But in South Indian food, there is one particular dish which our Ayurveda tells us that if we take it every day, it can help us increase our immunity significantly. Because these days, COVID se agar ladna hai, coronavirus se ladna hai agar, to uska ek hi answer hai ki our immunity should be strong. And which most young people have it inherently, but even those who are in their 40s, 50s, दे कैन ऑल्सो फर्दर इम्प्रूव इट देयर इम्यूनिटी एंड फाइट इट आउट. अगर आ भी जाता है तो 98% लोग ठीक हो जाते हैं. सो इम्यूनिटी एनहांस करने के लिए इन साउथ इंडियन फूड वन आइटम विच इज प्रूवन बाय आवर आयुर्वेदा वैद्य एंड अक्रॉस द यू नो ऑल द साइंटिस्ट आयुर्वेदा साइंटिस्ट इज रसम. आई डोंट नो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू लाइक रसम. When you go to, you know, South Indian restaurant, which is like a hot liquid soup, which is very tasty. It's easy to make, you know, in kitchen. And ever since, you know, we were told, I have been taking it every day. You know, immediately after this, at 1 o'clock, you know, I'm going to have my rasam. And it's so easy to cook. It just takes about 8 to 10 minutes. Yes, it's spicy. Anchal is saying it's spicy, but if you're making it at home, it is in your control. You put less spice. You need not put that much spicy, which you find it in Sagar Ratna or some other restaurants. And it, generally, I'm sure ladies would know it. Ki isme imli dalti hai, tamarind, which is a very, very good, you know, antiseptic as well as immunity builder also. Apart from that, isme kali mirch wagera, tomatoes and some other spices go. Ab YouTube pe jaiye. It's a very simple recipe. Just take 10 minutes. Aisa lagta hai ki it may be very difficult recipe to make, but no, it's very simple. It just takes 7 to 8 minutes to make it, and you can consume it every day. It's a good appetizer also, but it's a great immunity builder. And let me share with you, friends, that in our Omni Life, we have a panel of 15 or 16 resources who are experts in their own fields. And in Ayurveda, on our panel is Dr. Sudhinder Upur of Goa. You know who is world renowned, and he has told us that those who take rasam every day, 99.99% chances are that such people will never get cancer in their life. It has such lovely properties. And that is one reason why South Indian friends, you know, our people, friends living in South India, their immunity is better. Even in this COVID results also, it can be seen that the cases may be high, but they are getting cured and the fatalities are low. So these are some simple things. But rasam, as a practice, you know, you can add in your daily consumption things. And of course, things like we have to avoid junk food, processed food, refined foods, etc. And desi ghee is better than oil. So this is something which, you know, some of us do not agree, but this is what Ayurveda tells us, that desi ghee is better than the processed refined oil that some of us use it. Right, so yog is saying, we're coming to that, sir. We are discussing, we food discuss kar rahe hai, which is the first pillar. So I think we have had enough discussion as far as food is concerned, that we should space it up. 4 hours ki gap hona chahiye between two meals. And we've also discussed, you know, about how we should intake water and it should be room temperature, etc. And what kind of food we should avoid. And if we make these simple changes, this alone can add 5-10 years to our life, and not 5-10 just years, healthy years. So this is as far as the first pillar is concerned. So now we'll move to the second pillar, which many of you have already mentioned, is the fitness, or some people were saying yoga, and we name it movement. As simple as that, that we need to improve or increase our movement on a daily basis. So food that we eat, और कितना हम अपने शरीर को हिलाते हैं, हाउ मच एक्टिविटी वी डू, हाउ मच मूवमेंट कैन डू वी डू, एंड देयर इज ऑलवेज अ स्कोप फॉर इंप्रूवमेंट देयर. दीज टू आर द सिंपलेस्ट एंड द वाइडली नोन पिलर्स एज फार एज द ओमनी लाइफ इज कंसर्न. फिजिकल एक्टिविटी, यस, आंसर इज सेइंग. सो ओके, सो व्हाट आर आवर व्यूज व्हेन इट कम्स टू मूवमेंट. सो आई विल जस्ट गिव यू कपल ऑफ स्मॉल सेल्फ केयर प्रोटोकॉल्स. फर्स्ट, व्हेन इट कम्स टू मूवमेंट, वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट कि आप कोई सूर्य नमस्कार करिए 100, या कोई बड़े मुश्किल योगा के आपने कुछ वो करने हैं. इफ यू कैन डू दैट, वंडरफुल. और जिम जाना है, सो नो, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सेल्फ केयर प्रोटोकॉल्स वेयर विदाउट स्पेंडिंग मनी, घर पे ही छोटी छोटी चीजें जो आप कर सकते हैं, दैट इज व्हाट द होल आइडिया ऑफ द लाइफ इज. सो हियर फर्स्ट थिंग एज फार एज मूवमेंट इज कंसर्न्ड इज टू इंक्रीज योर स्टेप्स टू 10,000 स्टेप्स एवरी डे. दिस इज ए बेंचमार्क which the global medical profession has set for every person in the age group of, you know, 15 to 80, 10,000 steps. And you know, it's easy these days. You know, we have these Fitbits, ghadiyan aajkal aa gayi hain, where you can count ki kitna hai. I have done about 4,000 steps since morning, but I must complete 10,000 steps. You know, but although despite COVID, despite lockdown, you know, we can walk inside. We can walk from one room to the other, from front door to the back door, and it's ensured to. It's important to ensure that we keep moving, and so that you know, whatever we are eating gets digested. Our body, as well as mind, as well as spirit, it remains active. It remains energetic. On an average, each one of us we take about 3,000 to 6,000 steps. If you count them, apne takriban 3,000-5,000 lete hain, but we need to increase it to 10,000 steps by whichever way you count it. 1,500 steps is about 1 kilometer. 1 kilometer average 1,400 to 1,600 steps hote hain. Har ek ke steps chote bade hote hain. So which means ki humko 6 se 7 kilometer chalna hai. Then that also includes within the house movement. You know, from here to there. When the bell rings, then you get up yourself to go and open the door, rather telling your son or your maid to go and open the door. These are small, small things. Khud hi ja ke pani pi lena, fridge se nikal ke. So it adds to your activity. The other important thing about movement is not to sit continuously on your chair for more than 45 minutes. So if you cultivate this habit, I know you are professors, you are teachers, you know, aapko lagatar baith ke ki kaam karne padte hain. Like I will also be sitting now on this chair for some time, but this is an exception. So otherwise, 45 minutes se jada, if you do not sit continuously, that itself, you know, would keep your body very active. So avoiding sitting continuously for more than 45 minutes, 10,000 steps every day, and simple things like stretching, maybe, you know, Tadasana, etc. Very, very simple things, you know, which you can do are very good. Also avoiding stairs, lift. Agar hamara office second floor pe hai, first floor pe hai, to lift ko avoid kare. Agar hum seedhiyan chadh jaye, fatafat se utar jaye, so that itself you know, would keep us very, very active. And the most important thing when it comes to movement is if you cannot do any of these things, then best exercise is walking. And for walking, the Ayurveda tells us 45 minutes of brisk walk. So these four words are very important. 45 minutes brisk walk. Okay, for proper blood circulation, Dr. Nipinder Dwivedi is saying excellent. So why I'm saying 45 minutes? Because some of us, you know, we go for a walk in the morning, ek chakkar laga ke aa jaate hain park ka 20 minute ka, and then we say, oh, hum to road morning walk karte hain, hum to bade fit hain. So friends, 20 minutes is not enough. Even if you do 35 minutes, you see, I'm not saying it just as a guesstimate. I'm saying it's scientific evidence. If you walk for 35 minutes and if you increase your walk to 45 minutes, the results would be double. From 35 to 45, extra 10 minutes. Wo jo last ke 10 minutes hai, when your heart will start pumping at a higher speed, that is where thoda pasina jab aapko aana shuru hoga, that is the best possible benefit which your body will get. Only, you know, in those last 10 minutes. So it's important to walk for, yes, walking is balanced exercise, 45 minutes. And the other important thing which I mentioned is brisk walk. Brisk is very important because many of us, you know, hum log matak matak ke chalte hain ghar mein, jaise aram aram se waisi sair karte hue bhi chalte hain. If you go in the park, you see some people are walking slightly faster, but a lot of them are just tehl rahe hote hain. So jo tehl rahe hote hain, that is for their own good, but it's not doing any good to their body. Because we are talking here about living a longer life, living an active life, omni life, full of purpose. Our mind ekdam active. Uske liye it's important that we do detoxification of our inner body. Uske liye it's important to do little extra movement. So brisk walk means slightly faster than our normal speed. All of us have a normal speed. We know it ki hum kis speed se chalte hain. We need to increase it by 10-15% so that, you know, we feel inside, you know, we can feel the energy flowing, we can feel thoda thoda pasina aa raha hai humko. That is where the benefit, the heart will start pumping at a slightly faster rate, which is so very good for, you know, our health, for increasing our longevity. So 45 minutes a brisk walk, if we can include it as a daily routine, that would do wonder. That would add at least 5-10-15 years, you know, to our overall healthy active life. So this is as far as the movement is concerned. And of course, other things like yoga, etc., are very, very good. Alom vilom, and whatever, you know, some of you may be following, pranayama, etc., breathing, all these are additional. But here we are talking about simple to follow self-care protocols. Aapne dekha hoga, food mein bhi humne bilkul simple baatein kari, aur movement mein bhi humne bilkul simple baatein kari ki हमने 10,000 स्टेप्स करने हैं और हमने 45 मिनट से ज्यादा चेयर पे बैठना नहीं है और 45 मिनट्स की ब्रिस्क वॉक करनी है. इफ वी जस्ट टेक केयर ऑफ दीज 3-4 थिंग्स दैट इटसेल्फ इज गुड इनफ टू मेक आवर लाइफ यू नो मच मोर एंजॉयबल एंड मच मोर फुलफिलिंग. ओके, सो वी डिस्कस द टू सिंपल पिलर्स, फूड एंड मूवमेंट. नाउ कपाली भाती इज ऑल्सो गुड. यस, कपाल भाती. ओके, कपाल भाती. यस, कपाल भाती. ऑफ कोर्स कपाल भाती इज वेरी वेरी गुड एज पार्ट ऑफ द योगा रेजिम. यस, आई एम श्योर हम लोग सब बाबा रामदेव और दूसरे लोगों को भी देख चुके हैं टीवी पे. सो कपाल भाती, अलोम विलोम, प्राणायाम वगैरह, डीप ब्रीदिंग, ये सब बहुत ही अच्छे हैं हेल्थ के लिए इफ यू कैन डू इट रेगुलरली. एंड नाउ वील मूव टू द थर्ड पिलर. सो वी डिस्कस फूड एंड मूवमेंट. Aerobic exercise 15 minutes. Yes, excellent, Professor Pandey. That is very, very good. Everything that we are talking here, they are all additional points. If we also do that, if we also do Surya Namaskar, what would be wonderful with that? Nothing like that. But many of us do not even do the basic things, which is many of us are not even doing 10,000 steps in a day, if we count. You know, many of us are, like I said, हम लोग वॉक करते हैं बट 20-25 मिनट की दो चक्कर लगा के अपने लोकल पार्क के आ जाते हैं and we keep on saying in our entire life कि हम तो रोज वॉक करते हैं. So these are some of the small things that we need to take care of. Okay, now we will move to the third pillar. And third pillar is a pillar which is very very important, but somehow I didn't see that answer in any of the responses जो हम लोगों ने शुरू में दिए थे. Any guess? What could be the third pillar after food and movement? Right. Okay. So we have less time. So we will not consume time in guessing. We'll come to its state. Meditation. Calmness. Oh, Professor Tapan Nayak. Sir, you know it. Okay. Perfect. This is the third pillar. Third pillar you have mentioned is sleep. Sleep is the third, but we are not talking about it in any order. Ki food sabse jyada important hai. मूवमेंट नंबर टू, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. ऑल द 10 पिलर्स आर इक्वली इंपॉर्टेंट. ये जस्ट डिस्कसिंग देम इन रैंडम ऑर्डर बट वी स्टार्टेड विद सिंपल पिलर्स व्हिच ऑल ऑफ अस अंडरस्टैंड. नाउ वी आर कमिंग टू द स्लीप. सो स्लीप इज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पिलर बिकॉज इफ आवर स्लीप इज नॉट रेगुलेटेड, इफ आवर स्लीप इज नॉट हाई क्वालिटी, देन दैट मैनिफेस्ट्स इनटू लेथार्जीनेस, इनटू लेस एनर्जी, leading to irritation, leading to mental health issues, leading to anger, leading to bad digestion, leading to bad health, etc., etc. So sleep itself or deprivation of it or shortage of it can lead to many problems. And here the beautiful thing here about 10 pillars is that when we start working on one pillar, other pillars also start getting strengthened. For example, once we improve our sleep, sleep improve karte hi we will feel energetic, so we will be able to do 10,000 steps easily. We do 10,000 steps, whatever khana we are eating, we are digesting it in a much more effective manner. So immediately glow will come on our face within few days if we start working on one of them. All others get corrected. So now coming to the sleep, what are the self care protocols as far as the sleep is concerned? Professor Nayak ne bilkul sahi ekdam se bang on jawab de diya. हमारे जो रिसर्च बताती है वो ये है कि 6 to 8 hours ऑफ स्लीप इज वेरी एसेंशियल फॉर ईच वन ऑफ अस. सो 6 to 8 hours. सो इसमें कोई हार्ड एंड फास्ट रूल नहीं है कि 6 घंटे होने चाहिए, 8 घंटे होने चाहिए. 6 से कम अगर हो रहे हैं देन देयर इज सम इश्यू. 8 से ज्यादा हो रहे हैं, अगर ज्यादा सो रहे हैं तब भी कोई मेंटल इशू है. 8 से ज्यादा सोना भी इज नॉट गुड फॉर हेल्थ. सो एनीवेयर बिटवीन 6.5, 7, 7.5 विच इज एसेंशियल एंड एक्सलेंट फॉर ईच वन ऑफ अस. बट इट इज नॉट जस्ट द लेंथ ऑफ स्लीप, इट इज द क्वालिटी ऑफ स्लीप. कितनी जल्दी हम नींद हमें आ जाती है व्हेन वी लाई डाउन ऑन बेड. क्या हम 5 मिनट में सो जाते हैं या आधा घंटा हमें वो फोन उठा के देखना पड़ता है. वी आर स्ट्रगलिंग विद आवर आईपैड और यू नो एंड वी आर टेकिंग साइड्स एंड वी आर नॉट एबल टू स्लीप. सो दीज आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग्स दैट वी नीड टू अटेंड टू व्हेन इट कम्स टू स्लीप. इट शुड बी साउंड स्लीप, लाइक डॉक्टर नृपेंद्र द्विवेदी सर इज सेइंग, इट शुड बी साउंड स्लीप, undisturbed sleep, रात को बिना उठे sleep. Many of us get up 2-3 times. That is not, again, not good signs of good health if we are getting up in the middle of the night for whatever. So if our sleep is getting disturbed, if slightest noise, if our sleep gets disturbed, again, it's not good sign. Okay, so 6 to 8 hours of sound sleep. And the most important part about sleep is that your time to go to bed and time to get up from bed should be predefined and disciplined. which means ki Dr. Sunaina Jain madam, you agree with me ki ek time fix ho jaye sone ka, 11 baje sone ka, subah 6 baje uthne ka, ya 10:30 sone ka, 5:30 uthne ka, you can fix your own time, usme koi hard and fast rule nahi hai, but if you can manage to get to a discipline of getting to a bed at a fixed time and getting up in the morning at a fixed time, 95% of times at least, that will do a lot of good to your overall physique, your overall personality, your overall mood, and your overall well-being. So sleep ke agar hum time regulate karte hain, because I'm sure hum log to, all of you are very educated and you are professors yourself, so you are taking very good care. But there are students also, I believe those who are listening, and we know that students are in the habit of keeping up
late
to
night.
2 baje tak, to ha, 2 baje tak jaag rahe hain, 1 baje tak jaag rahe hain, subah Sunday ko 10 baje uth rahe hain, 11 baje uth rahe hain. So that actually is not, in the long run, it definitely affects the overall well-being, the overall health, mental as well as physical health of these people. And that is where, you know, people get into some lifestyle diseases and they are in their mid-30s, mid-40s. When they are 20-25, it, but things keep start developing inside your body if you are not taking care of it, like, you know, good amount of sleep, etc. The other thing about sleep is that we must take, as per Ayurveda, I'm telling you now. So this again, I must qualify my statement again. I'm not a doctor, I'm sure, as you know. I'm just sharing the research which we have done, the wisdom which we have collected from others, like from you. I'm collecting some wisdom from you, which I'll share with others whenever I get a chance to share with others. When it comes to sleep, as per Ayurveda, sleeping during the day is prohibited, is not good for health, is banned. So what it means is ki kai bari hum din mein bed pe aise so jate hain jaise raat ko sote hain pura lamba hoke, and we sleep for an hour and a half, two, bilkul puri pakki neend mein so jate hain, which is not good as per Ayurveda. They say that aapne sirf raat ko hi sona hai, ek hi bari sona hai 7-8 ghante ke liye, din mein you should take nap, jhapki, at least two times sitting on a chair, sitting on a sofa in a comfortable position, you know, you shut your eyes and for 5-10 minutes you take a nap. That will do you wonderfully good to when it comes to your energy levels, when it comes to your overall preparing you for the next few hours of activity. So taking two naps at least will do a lot of good, you know, to your physical thing. Yes, so doctor, yeah, 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. Excellent, sir. We'll try and follow your 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. Right now, I'm doing 11 p.m. to 6 a.m., which is about 7 hours. But if we can increase it to 8 hours, we'll do. Short nap daily provides energy. Yes, Anchal is agreeing with me. That gives me happiness. Yes, so two naps of 5 to 10 minutes. Try avoiding completely, because these days when we are locked down inside our houses, then there is not much to do, you know, many a times. And then there is a tendency to lie down on the bed, raat ko neend nahi aa rahi hai, din mein so rahe hain, etc. So which is actually not good in the long run. So when it comes to sleep, these are some of the self-care protocols. And the other important thing is that we should avoid having a television in our bedroom, which again is considered not good, and because it affects the quality of sleep. And also the other important thing is to reduce our screen time, particularly before sleeping. So if we can stay away from a television screen and a mobile phone screen and an iPad screen and a laptop screen at least 1 hour before we go to bed, then our eyes will be properly rested and we will get to sleep quickly, and our sleep will also of a higher quality, deeper in terms of giving rest to our body. So if we can stay away from the screen for some time before we go to sleep, that is a good inducement to sleep. And I'm sure all of you know, you have been great students. That is how you have reached this stage, that reading good books is an excellent antidote before you go to sleep. So if you have some good inspirational books, motivational books, autobiographical books, whatever books you like, wo aap raat ko sone se pehle thoda sa padhiye, 10 minute, 15 minute, your eyes will get little heavy, and then you go to sleep, you will get to sleep quickly. And that would, make your night very, very full of repair, rejuvenating. So you get up in the morning, much more energetic, and be ready to take the day as it comes. So friends, this is the third pillar, which is sleep apart from food and movement. And as I've been mentioning, all the pillars are interconnected. Any comments so far that we have discussed? Any other thing as far as sleep is concerned? Dr. Singh, you want to say something? Okay.
Yeah, I just wanted to ask you one thing, Anil sir. Yeah. You spoke about equal to 45 minutes walking, right?
Yes.
So again, it depends on the person.
Yes.
How much he can afford to do.
Yes.
So you cannot like impose views. No. Again, it is up to you, you know.
Whatever I'm saying, I agree with you. These are not possible for everybody to follow. What we are talking here is general suggestions, which should be picked up by 95% of people, because there may be some medical conditions for some people. So that is our self-care protocols for us to consider and to include it in our daily lifestyle if we can. So obviously, if somebody is so busy कि वो 45 मिनट्स के वॉक नहीं कर सकते एक टाइम पे, दे कैन स्लोली स्लोली इंक्रीज, दे कैन स्लोली. सो ओके, सो आई एम वेरी क्लियर हियर व्हेन इट कम्स टू यू नो अंडरस्टैंडिंग द सेल्फ केयर प्रोटोकॉल. दीज आर नॉट प्रेस्क्रिप्टिव, दीज आर जस्ट रिकमेंडेशंस. सो एंड वी आर मेकिंग नॉट वन और टू, वी आर मेकिंग सेवरल रिकमेंडेशंस. इवन इफ यू पिक अप 30-40% आउट ऑफ दीज, सपोजिंग we were earlier walking 20 minutes, we start walking 28 minutes, 35 minutes, that itself is some benefit, right? So if we cannot go up to right up to 45, but we must make, you know, some improvements. Okay. So we have had discussions on food, movement and sleep. And now we will go to the fourth pillar. And the fourth pillar, friends, I can see Mr. Govind Srivastava also here listening very attentively. The fourth pillar is stress, or we call it de-stress. So again, I am sure all of you would agree that stress has become a part of our life, which means that all of us have some or the other kind of stress every time. So stress is not bad. I'm sure you all understand this. Stress is integral part of our daily life. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Right. So the different kinds of stresses are, बच्चों के एडमिशन नहीं हो रहे, उनके एग्जाम कैसे होंगे, उन्होंने यूएसए जाना था पढ़ाई के लिए, अब क्या होगा, कोविड हो गया, ऑफिस कब खुलेंगे, यू नो देयर आर हजार काइंड्स ऑफ स्ट्रेस. घर में कोई बीमार है, ओल्ड रिलेटिव रहता है, ही इज नॉट वेल, किसी को कोई बीमारी है एक्सेट्रा. सो फाइनेंशियल स्ट्रेस है कि हमारे पास इतनी हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस नहीं है, इस चीज का स्ट्रेस है, रिलेशनशिप में स्ट्रेस है. सो देयर आर थाउजेंड्स टाइप्स ऑफ स्ट्रेसेस दैट वी आर लिविंग विद, बट वी आर नॉट सेइंग दैट स्ट्रेस इज बैड. गुड स्ट्रेस, नॉट बैड स्ट्रेसेस. Exactly, मैं अभी वही बोल रहा था. The fourth pillar is about how to mitigate stress, how to reduce stress, how to manage stress. Okay, so we cannot eliminate stress. It's just not possible. Just not possible. We all have to learn to live with stress, but it's important to learn some de-stressing techniques, because if we continue to live with high stress, then definitely it affects our sleep. You agree? When we are stressed, we are not able to have good sleep. And then if we are not able to have good sleep, next day, you know, our energy levels are low. But we still continue to eat, and we continue to, sometimes we eat more because, you know, we are feeling lethargic. You know, we go for processed food, we go for junk foods, we have digestion problems, we add weight, and then it leads to different complications, and that limits the overall longevity expectation that we started with, you know, our discussion. So stress is again a very important pillar on which we need to work. Yes, Dr. Shalinder is saying COVID-19 has led more stress, but at the same time I agree, but I am sure you would also agree with me that in last 40 days or so, jo hum gharon mein apne band hai, we have been doing a lot of different kind of thinking also in our mind. Kuch ऐसे इंट्रोस्पेक्शन किया होगा हमने कि बिकॉज दिस इज एन इवेंट विच हैज हैपेंड अनप्रेसिडेंटेड फॉर श्योर फर्स्ट टाइम इन ईच वन ऑफ आवर लाइफ्स. ऐसा कभी भी हमने नहीं देखा दैट वी आर लॉकडाउन इन आवर हाउस कंटिन्यूअसली फॉर 40-50 डेज. इट्स इन ए वंस इन अ लाइफ टाइम, बिकॉज लास्ट फ्लू वाज ओवर 100 इयर्स अगो. So it has actually forced us to do some introspection, and it has a humbling effect on all of us. We must be making resolutions ki jab sab kuch normal hoga to main aise karunga, wo karunga, I will make this change, I will make that change, because we are going through this new thinking and we are getting ready for this new normal, and it would make all of us, you know, a better person in terms of when how to conduct, because we have seen such a calamity from such closeness, and we have realized ki the life is actually so fragile that we need to enjoy whatever life we have, and we need to make certain changes, you know, in our day-to-day working. And I'm sure all of us have undergone, you know, similar thoughts in our minds, and we will start enacting them as soon as, you know, the life returns to normalcy. Now, coming back to the pillar, which is stress. Now, we need to know what are the stress-busting mechanisms that all of us have. All of us have our own ways of busting the stress. We can share with you, jo humne global research kari, that most people, how do they reduce? Yes, music is perfect answer. That is the first answer. So, Gaurav Baba, well done. Music, listening to our favorite music is one of the great stress reducers or busters. Yes or no? All of us have our own favorite genres of music, right? Some of us love bhajan, some of us love, you know, qawwali, some of us love ghazals, some of us like 60s music or 90s music, film music, non-film music, you know, and jazz music or classical, etc., etc. But we all have some likings, and if we listen to our favorite music, it definitely reduces our stress, it elevates our mood, and that leads to being more productive. So yes, so music is very, very important. Then of course, literature, reading good books are again good stress busters. And the other thing is playing, yes, meditation, be rational. What about playing with small children in our family? Do we feel energized when we talk to small children, you know, 2 saal ke, 5 saal ke, 6 mahine ke? So if we are lucky to have small children in our family, I'm not saying everyone will feel, you know, stress relieved, but 80-90% of us would, you know, feel immediate reduction in our stress once we play with small children. And that same is also true for pets. I don't know how many of us, because in India, it's not very common to keep pets, but whatever, whosoever, you know, we have pets in our houses, they say that it's a great stress buster. We come and play with our, you know, with our pet dogs or cats or whatever, mostly it is dogs, and we feel so relaxed and we feel so nice, you know, after spending some time with them, because they emote, they show such nice emotions, and we feel, you know, suddenly we feel that it is making a good impact on our mood, etc. So talking to parents every day helps a lot. Yes, exactly, Dr. Smita Agarwal. Talking to friends, chatting with friends, chatting with colleagues, chatting to your parents, chatting with your siblings. Again, stress buster, ghar ki bikri hui cheezon ko sajaya jaye. Yes, ghar ki bikri hui cheezon. So yes, so you have your own ways of how to combat or how to minimize stress. But it's important. So we have learned a lot of things, but it's important to be aware of it, that stress will be there, but we have to reduce it, we have to bust it, we have to minimize it. And the ways are meditation, be with nature. Ways are spending time with children, spending time with parents, talking to your friends. Aap dost se phone mein baat karte ho, 5-10 minute apni saheli se baat karte ho, and suddenly, you know, your mood gets so better, you feel so energized, and stress goes away. Similarly, reading books, listening to music, playing with pets, all these are excellent, you know, stress busters. Now, so obviously following our hobbies, whatever hobbies we have, we may have different hobbies, musical instruments. Some of us like to play flute or any other, you know, mouth organ, etc. So all these are, and maybe some of us like to hum, you know, songs. So you can, without disturbing others, you know, you can kill your stress by singing some songs, you know, of your favorite choice, etc. So it's important to be aware of stress and to do small, small things which would help us reduce our stress. So we'll move to the fifth pillar now. The fifth pillar is, so let us remind ourselves that we are discussing aspects of life on which we need to pay attention in order to not only live a longer life, but to live a fuller life, to live a life full of vitality, to live a life full of energy, purpose, you know, so that we feel proud about it, so that others also, you know, relate to us as successful people. We have a strong desire to be known as successful people, somebody who lives a life king size. So the next pillar that we are going to discuss is attitude. Attitude actually, again, leads to so many other complications. And we would have seen in and around us, amongst neighbors, amongst families, amongst our parents or brothers, sisters, that people who have a negative attitude or a irritating attitude or a complaining attitude actually develop a lot of physical complications and do not tend to live longer. There is a strong correlation. When it comes to, of course, it is very easy to say that have a positive attitude. There is, everybody knows this, to have a positive attitude. But what are the various steps that we need to take to improve our attitude? I will give you what our research tells us, and then you can also add. So one is that to reduce or give up completely complaining about anything. Complaining does not help even one bit. Taking action does. Of course, if you are feeling a problem with something, if you just keep complaining about it, it will result in, you know, stress, it will result in some negative attitude, and it would, you know, then give rise to the other complications. So, for example, we are going through this COVID. Instead of just keep complaining, ki Modi ji ne ye kar diya, Kejriwal sahab ne ye kar diya, ye dukan khol di, wo dukan band kar di, you know, instead of just, some people have this habit of continuing to complain about anything and everything that goes around them, and that is, you know, where the complications start coming up. So we need to master this art of complaining less, minimum, or even zero, because it doesn't help even one bit. So one is have a complaint-free day. So if you decide, get up in the morning and you decide that today, next whole 15 hours till I sleep, I will not make even a single complaint about anything, about any expectation that, you know, may not come true, I will not complain about it. You see that how nice you will feel, how the mood of the whole family will get elevated, and you know, you'll have a wonderful day, and in the evening, you will really thank yourself. And so slowly, slowly, by practicing this, you can make your life, if not completely complaint-free, then maybe 90% complaint-free. So because less complaining would lead to positive attitude. The other thing is having a forgiving nature. So if you practice this task of forgiving, because they say that when you forgive, when one person forgives, two people get healed. Do you agree with this? That when one person forgives other, so not only the person who is being forgiven, he is healed, but the person who is actually forgiving, she also gets healed. So one forgiving, two persons get healed. So it's very important to have a, because it's a short life, it's a small life, and we cannot keep on continuing with grudges inside our heart, because once we give space to grudges inside our heart and we keep creeping about it, complaining about it, then of course it leads to stress, it leads to you know, other complications, and they all then lead to various physical problems also. So yes, one may not forget but can forgive. Yes, Professor Pandey is saying. Okay, but I think, sir, even forgetting also is very important, because if you are just forgiving but not forgetting, again you are keeping somewhere inside your heart which will keep troubling you.
So, I'll tell you what happens is that when you look at people who are depressed, often, yes, I wrote that earlier also, people allow their emotions to ride over their thoughts. Right. The key to staying healthy is, because man has a gargantuan memory. We are the only animal which has, you know, our brain, the frontal cortex, which contains memory, has billions and trillions of cells. So it is very difficult to forget. Only thing is that we come to peace with whatever we wish to forget. Say a bad boss, People don't leave organizations. They only leave their bosses. Right. So, point is that I simply believe that there are bad events. Like, people are unable to come to term. I saw a wonderful movie, 2019. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Tom Hanks. 2019. And everybody should watch it. It's about Fred Rogers. Fred Rogers created a system. He was the biggest TV star between 1965 to 2003 when he passed away with stomach cancer. What he used to do, the entire film, the script of the film is about a man who has a problem with his father since childhood because he felt that when his mother was dying, the father did not take care of the mother. And there's an unresolved conflict. But, you know, there are several experts. I do a lot of readings on this. They say that, you know, you cannot resolve, you know, your problems, but you can definitely resolve your psychological conflict. So Fred Rogers helps a man meet his father who has suffered a heart attack, and the movie ends with the father dying and the son resolving all his conflicts with his father, realizing that, yes, there were circumstances under which my father did that. But we'll discuss this later. I'll not take your time.
Sure. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Dr. Pandey, for this interjection. And friends, the simple point which we're trying to make is that in learning the art of forgiving itself would make you, you know, will give you such a wonderful feeling of as if you are contributing to society something, you are becoming a nobler person, and that itself will add to your mental confidence, and that itself would add life to your ears. Of course, ears will also be added separately. So, and even they say that bad memory is a good virtue. You know, if you have the ability to forget, like Professor Pandey was saying, that it is difficult to forget but easy to forgive. But I would say go one step further, forgive, and as well as try to forget, don't keep grudges inside your heart. Now, coming to attitude, other steps that one needs to take is, apart from forgiving and not complaining and not worrying, because if you worry, then you are robbing, you know, happiness of your future, because it doesn't help by worrying. What needs to be done is to taking action. The other important thing is, do not please compare. Comparison only brings grief. Comparison with anybody on this earth, because you do not know, there may be people who are envying the life which you are living. They want to be like what you are today. So do not try and compare yourself with anybody, because that only brings pain, that only brings grief. So comparison doesn't do any good to anybody. So not to compare, not to worry, not to complain, to forgive, and finally regretting. Regretting also is not at all going to help us. So when it comes to attitude, we need to inculcate these small self-care protocols of reducing our tendency to complain or to worry or to regret or to compare. And of course, to include forgive. Professor Naik, you wanted to say something, sir? Professor Naik, did you want to? I thought you wanted to say something.
You unmute yourself, Naik ji.
No, it's okay. बहुत अच्छा चल रहा है चोपड़ा साहब, प्लीज गो अहेड.
नहीं, इसमें बस सर एक लाइन में ऐड कर दूंगा, वी कांट बिकम समवन एल्स बट वी कैन ओनली बिकम द बेस्ट वर्जन ऑफ आवरसेल्फ्स.
एग्जैक्टली.
सो ये एक इशू होता है
वो. राइट.
यू हैव टेकन वर्ड्स फ्रॉम माय माउथ. आई वाज अबाउट टू से दिस कि कंपेयर अगर आपने करना अपने आप से करिए, बेंचमार्क यू, सो दैट एवरी डे यू ट्राई टू बिकम अ बेटर पर्सन देन व्हाट यू वर यस्टरडे. सो योर बेंचमार्क, वेदर इट इज योर हेल्थ, that even in terms of money matters also, we say that financial well-being is practiced only if today you have more money than what you have tomorrow. So if you're, it may be only 10 rupees more, or maybe only 100,000 rupees more, but as long as every year you are adding to your overall, you know, corpus or finance. So the benchmark should not be ki Mukesh Ambani ke paas 28,000 crore hai ya uske paas 3 crore hai, mere paas 1.5 crore hai. Benchmark should be what we have and whether we are able to improve it, sustain it, and increase it as far as, you know, our own situation is concerned. So this is as far as the attitude is concerned. So we have discussed now food, movement, sleep, stress, and attitude as 5 pillars. And now we'll move on to the next pillar, which is ecosystem or the environment in which we live. When it comes to ecosystem, we owe it to the community, to the society, to the country, to the city where we are born, and it's our duty to ensure that we contribute in whatever way we can. Yes, responsibility towards the nature. Anchal is really helping me a lot with her thoughts. You know, we can start with doing as small things as having, you know, small indoor plants inside our house. let us, you know, like they say, charity begins at home. So there are a lot of from nurseries, you know, one can buy very cheap, not so expensive indoor plants, which help us keep the oxygen level at a better level inside our home. Let us start it from there, from our living rooms and from our bedrooms. They don't even need sunlight, etc. You just need to water them a little bit. I'm sure all of you know it. But if we start taking care of these small things and increase the hygiene, the internal hygiene of our home, and then, you know, doing a little bit outside our homes, putting some plants, etc. there, and then the office where we work, and in the entire ecosystem of our neighborhood, our community, our RWA, wherever we live, etc. If we can contribute there in terms of improving the environment, reducing the pollution, that itself, we will do a lot of good, not only to your and your families, but to the society around you. And that itself gives a lot of self-satisfaction that you are contributing to the society, spending time in sunshine, excellent air around trees. Yes, these are some good self-care protocols of improving the ecosystem. So ecosystem is the sixth pillar. And now we'll come to the seventh pillar, for which Bajaj Capital is already well known, and many of you mentioned also, which is a financial well-being. So do you agree that money makes the mare go? And of course, we need a good amount of funds, financial planning, portfolio, and different kinds of investments to make sure that if we actually happen to live longer, then we should be living it in style. We should be taking care of all our necessities and our ambitions and our goals. And for that, the financial discipline, even from your young age, is very important. And so all of you can take help of the financial planners that we have. When it comes to financial well-being, it is our relationship with the money that we have, because many stresses are born out of the financial problems that we have. So when it comes to knowing the causes of the stress, then money matters, or finance comes out as one of the important reasons for stress amongst relationships, etc. But if we take good steps towards building a nice portfolio, the steps in financial well-being are that we make a list of our overall financial goals, which is the important goals are education of our children, college education, the fees that we need to plan for the children, then their marriage, and then our own retirement. And so if we take care of these three important goals, children education, children marriage, and retirement. And even if we retire at 60, because we are planning to live up to 100, so that means we have 40 more years to take care of. In those 40 years, inflation bhi hoga, and but you will, because you will be improving your health, you would like to roam around, you like to be to going different countries of the globe, you would like to go different stations of India from time to time, and you would like to have some club memberships, you like to have some your own lifestyle. For all that, you will need good financial planning, and for all that, you will need good corpus and invested, in such a manner that you keep on getting the amounts whenever they are needed, and there is no financial shock, which you cannot absorb, whether it is a medical emergency or whether it is any other planned or unplanned expense. So that kind of financial well-being is important, but that can happen only when we practice discipline right from the time when we start earning. So which means that I'll give you some simple thumb rules when it comes to financial well-being. The first thumb rule is that we must save at least 30% of our monthly earnings. At least 30%, that is, if we are not doing it, then maybe we are enjoying a little bit more in our current time, but our future will be suffering. In future, we'll not be able to sustain our lifestyle or do all the things that we want to do when we get to those years. And so, there is a general saying that salary doesn't make you rich. If there are two people, ek ki salary 2 lakh rupay mahine ki hai, ek lakh rupay mahine ki hai, that doesn't mean the one who is making 2 lakh is richer than the one who is making 1 lakh. It is the spending habits which make you rich. So if you control your spending habits, and if you keep your spending habits under your income, under your salaries, then you are rich, not the other way around. So it's important to have, these disciplines right from the beginning, making a list of your financial plans. First rule, as I mentioned, is 30% of your monthly earnings must be saved and invested in various long-term goals. The second thumb rule is that we must know different asset classes, which are debt, equity, gold and real estate, etc. But the thumb rule is that 100 minus your age should be invested in equity. Which means if you are 50 years today, then 50% should be invested in equity and 40% in debt and 10% in gold. But if you are only 30 years now, you can afford to invest 70% in equity and take the advantages of a rising global economy in the years to come. So these are some of the protocols or thumb rules that we need to follow. Asset allocation, starting early and investing in different asset classes, and also reviewing your portfolio, you know, every 3 to 6 months, and making a list of your goals. And the other important financial well-being principle is that we must have enough protection also. So for protection, one of the important thing is to have a good health insurance policy. Now we have noted that in this coronavirus thing, we have heard a lot of people are getting sick and they go to hospitals and very expensive treatments are required. Of course, 95% people, 98% people get cured and they come back. But they come back after spending good amount at the hospital. So if we have a good health insurance policy, that will take care. So we will not be have to worry extra about, you know, our treatment, etc. So health insurance, when it comes to the general thumb rule, is that if you are young with one or two small children, then 5 lakh rupees is minimum required. Minimum, I'm not saying enough. I'm saying minimum, because a lot of us have only 2 lakh, 3 lakh policy, that is not enough. So 5 lakh for young couples. And if you have old parents with you, living dependent upon you, then you must have a family floater of health insurance, a minimum 10 lakhs rupees. Minimum, I'm saying. So if you want to do it 15, 20, 25, and you can afford it, well and good. But 5 lakhs for young couple and 10 lakhs with parents of health insurance plan is important. Then you must have a term plan or a life insurance cover, which should be 7 to 10 times of your annual earnings. If your annual earning is 20 lakhs, 1.5 crore ka aapke paas life insurance cover hona chahiye. If your annual earning is 10 lakhs, then you must have at least 70 lakhs to 1 crore. So about 7 to 10 times of your annual earning should be a term plan. If you are a healthy, non-smoking male, you know, 30 saal ke agar hai, to jo 10 lakh ka plan bhi hai, wo 15,000 mil jata hai. It's not very expensive. Term plan is something very affordable, and our offices can help you. The other thing which I want to share with you is, friends, that all these 10 pillars that we are discussing here today, for each of these 10 pillars, we have experts on our panel in Omni Life. So for health-related matters, we have Dr. Upur, and we have, for sleep, we have Dr. Manmeer Bhatia. She is a India ke number one sleep expert from Delhi. And similarly for nutrition, you know, we have Anjali Huda and some of the other experts. For each of these pillars, we have resources. So if any one of you wants an extra session for financial well-being or for stress or for attitude, we have experts, you know, meditation experts, some yoga gurus who can give you separate sessions to help you work on those pillars. So now we discuss the financial well-being, and I have told you about the important thumb rules, which is 30% of your salary must be saved, and 100 minus your age should be invested in equity. 5 to 10 lakhs ki health insurance plan hona chahiye. NPS is a very important instrument for your pension planning, for your future pension type of income, for your retirement planning, etc. PPF, I'm sure all of you have, which is a must for everybody, a public provident fund account. And then there are other very, very good ways of creating wealth, you know, like investing through mutual fund SIPs in a diversified equity portfolio, and then also taking help of SWP, which is systematic withdrawal plan, after you retire for a pension kind of income. So I do not want to spend a lot of time on this, because financial well-being itself is a complete topic for 2 hours to go into details. But financial well-being is an important pillar in Omni Life, in ensuring that we live a good life, because money may not be everything, but it is important to enjoy, to take care of, you know, our necessities, our ambitions, our goals that all of us have. So, and that adds to our mental confidence, that adds to our overall personality. If we have good, if we have planned well, if we know that whenever money is needed, it is there, then that gives us extra confidence, and that reflects in our physical health also. So lack of money actually leads to a lot of stress and a lot of physical problems. Right. Okay. And so now next is spirituality. The financial well-being was the the eighth. So spirituality is something, you know, it's not being religious. It's not going to temple or, you know, going to church, etc. Spirituality is if we have a faith, you know, in a overall system, if we surrender ourselves to a bigger force, that itself is being spiritual. If we give back to society, if we help others, if we help anybody who is in need, that also is being spiritual. And I'm sure you have your own definitions of how to be spiritual. But our simple definition is that if you surrender yourself, for example, we couldn't do anything about this pandemic. We all stayed inside our houses. We followed, you know, the instructions, the guidelines of the government or of the local authorities. And our self-belief that, yes, this is the best thing to do. So that also is being spiritual. And if we just help anybody, not necessarily, you know, a poor person, but in our society, in our neighborhood, etc. So that itself is being spiritual. So now we'll come to the ninth pillar. Ninth pillar is something which was mentioned by few of you in the beginning, but some researchers feel that this is the most important pillar. And in fact, there was a research done by Harvard scientists, some professors. They did the research for 70 years. For 70 years from 1930 to 2000, 70 saal tak research karte rahe, just to find out the reasons ki what causes longevity, why some people live longer. And so in their research, this nine number pillar was number one reason. But we are going to share with you, the pillar was relationships. Those who have strong relationships, healthy relationships with their friends, with their family, with their spouse, with their children, with their neighbors, with their colleagues, they live longer. It's as simple as that. There is no, not much to discuss here. So healthy relationships keep, you know, a person in good spirits, and the person is feels wanted, that person feels important. So to be you know, friendly in nature, to be contacting all these friends, family members, those who stay in touch with the friend, those who chat with them, they meet often, whether in the morning in the park area or in the evening in the club. So on the other hand, solitude or loneliness is the killer. So those who do not enjoy good relationships, those who do not have many friends, it has been seen by the scientists that they get into mental health, Alzheimer's, and, you know, all those dementia kind of problems, and then they leave this world early. On the other hand, most of the people, those who live longer, have healthy relationships with their family members, with their children, grandchildren, spouse, of course, spouse most important, friends, neighbors, etc., etc. So relationships, again, is very, very important pillar. And now coming to the, because we have less time, coming to the last pillar, the pillar number 10 is something, again, very important. It's known as Ikigai. It's a Japanese word, but it's actually translated into English. It means purpose of life. I'm sure aap logon ne suna hoga ki bhai jo log busy rehte hain, wo jinda rehte hain zyada tar. It's important to remain busy. It's important to remain productive. It's important to remain doing something. So Ikigai actually means that if you have a purpose in life and you are following that, then age will not come in your way even when you have become 100, because that is what will make you spring out of your bed in the morning. Every day in the morning, you would be wanting to get ready and go and pursue your Ikigai, your purpose of life. And so Ikigai essentially means that if you know what you are good at, and if you know you are passionate about it, and if you know that the world needs it, whatever profession you have, and if you know that the world is ready to pay you for that, then that is Ikigai. So for example, for teachers, it is very easy that you are good at teaching, you are passionate about it, you love what you do, you know the world needs it, because there is so much of education needs which are there in the society which you are fulfilling, and people are ready to pay you that also. So if you continue to follow your Ikigai of spreading knowledge, of imparting education to whatever best you can, and you are passionate about it, people are ready to pay you for that, that becomes your Ikigai. And just to close with you know, one small example, that Mr. Rajiv Bajaj, our chairman, when he went to Okinawa in Japan, where a lot of people were living beyond the 100 years of age, and he spent 3-4 days there. He lived there in that village to see ki ye log kya karte hain, kaise, what is their routine, etc. So there he met you know, a 97-year-old lady who was still very active, cycle chalati hai 97 years ki. And she had the ikigai of, you know, she had a garden of vegetables in front of her house. Every day in the morning, you know, she'll go up and she'll do something, you know, in her farm and take out some fresh vegetables. And in her front room, she had a small restaurant where she'll cook those vegetables every day, you know, different local vegetables. And people will come and during the lunchtime, they will eat their food there. So, and that is what kept her very passionate about it, that local vegetables वहाँ पे उगा रही हैं. फ्रेंड्स बने हुए हैं, लोग आके लंच कर रहे हैं उनके साथ, हालचाल पूछ रहे हैं, दूसरे का रिलेशनशिप स्ट्रॉन्ग है, मनी उनको आ रही है. एंड इवन एट 97 शी फेल्ट लाइक एज इफ शी इज 55 और 60. सो दिस इज जस्ट अ सिंपल एग्जांपल ऑफ बीइंग गुड एट समथिंग, फॉलोइंग दैट एज अ प्रोफेशन, देन ऑफरिंग इट टू द वर्ल्ड एंड अर्निंग मनी आउट ऑफ इट. सो फ्रेंड्स, दैट इज व्हाट द ऑल 10 पिलर्स ऑफ ओमनी लाइफ आर ऑल अबाउट. एंड इफ फॉलोड इन टोटैलिटी, देन ऑल ऑफ अस कैन डेफिनेटली होप to lead a much fulfilling life, a much brighter life, much life full of zeal, life full of energy and vitality. So that is all I had to share with you. Sorry for overshooting the time, but I would be happy to have a comment or any other
thank you, sir. Thank you. We can keep this floor open for maybe 5 to 10 minutes for questions.
Yes,
from the audience, if any.
Right, yes, I can read the comments are
audience,
coming.
Audience, if you can ask your question. Yeah.
Okay, thank you, sir, for your deliberations. Dr. Sudhir Singh is saying.
Sir, I would like to just share my views on the session. It was a wonderful session. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Sir, you're not audible.
Sir, now am I audible?
Yes, sir, I just wanted to say it
was a wonderful session. I really thoroughly enjoyed it and I'll try my best to practice this in my life. Though I try now as well, I'm following most of the things which you have discussed today in the session. Almost, but still, because it is really very difficult to practice in the practical life when we face the challenges of life at every step. But definitely, I'll try to follow and I'll try to discuss with my family as well. And I believe if I can make changes in myself, maybe my family will also try to follow, especially my daughter. And that is what I believe. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Sorry,
sir. Sir, I love cooking. My family loves cooking. So daily during this lockdown period, I'm cooking something or the other. And we are very fond of South Indian food. So at least once in a week, I cook South Indian food. And I definitely cook rasam. We all like spicy food. So rasam is a part of it. We prepare kadha at home to increase our immunity. And all the plants we have around 150 ped hamare ghar mein hai. My father is very fond of gardening, like you were discussing about that 97-year-old lady. So he's a senior citizen and he believes in gardening and planting. So we have a Jurassic world at my home, what I can say. And we love that kadha, and we are practicing all those things. At least we try to practice. So from my side, thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. It was really an enriching session for each one of us, I believe. And I would ditto Achal for this, that maximum of things we have been adopting, especially I would talk about the attitude thing. I have been firmly believing, and where Pandey sir was also saying that you need to learn to forgive, not to forget. But I am of the opinion what you said, because I tell you, this has happened in past 10 years since I started practicing this, that the moment you start forgiving entirely, life has become beautiful.
Excellent.
Jain philosophy to nahi hai. Jain philosophy hai.
Sir, ye personal philosophy hai.
Sari philosophy hai.
Sir, I attended one of the session, to be very precise. I attended one of the session on magic of gratitude, actually. So from there I started practicing this thing.
Excellent.
Anil sir, I believe that, you know, if you cannot forget, then what you can do, you can leave to God, you know, because it's a human nature, you know, it's not so easy to forget also things, because memory, you know, it is there actually. So you can leave to God, you know, because you actually cannot do. Right now also we are facing natural calamity, which we are we cannot help also. So it's so better we leave to God and we do our karmas. We do our karmas that rest. Yes, sir.
You are being spiritual. You know, aapne jo bola abhi, leave it to
yeah,
God.
Actually.
Which is one of the pillars.
Yeah.
So I think I would like to add here about forgetting thing. So I read somewhere that whenever something bad happens to you, so you need to think like this, that will it matter in 5 minutes? Will it matter for 5 days? Will it matter for 5 months? Or will it matter for 5 years? Now, the moment you put this criteria, importance of whatever is hurting you will immediately become clear to you. And if you combine this with what sir said, what Anil sir said, purposefulness. So if you have a purpose in life and if something is hurting you, the moment you realize you have a purpose in life, you will know that if I keep on fretting about it, I will lose my purpose. So I think purpose will keep you on track. That's my take on it.
Right.
Excellent. Good point.
Chopra sahab, aap agar dekhen, there are no questions. All compliments are there on the chat box. So this shows how wonderful this session was. If I want to recall the 10 points which you have said, start put food, continuous movements, 6 to 8 hours sleep. Less stress. Following our hobbies.
Yes.
Think he's sharing the screen.
Yeah.
Okay.
All the points.
Okay. Yes.
Yes. There
right,
it is.
Right. एंड अगर हम ये 10 मंत्रा को हम फॉलो करना सीख ले तो कोविड क्या उसका भाई डेविड आने के बाद भी कुछ नहीं होगा सो बिफोर वी बाइंड अप आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट डायरेक्टर प्रोफेसर आलोक पांडे टू से फ्यू वर्ड्स सर
हे सर इट वाज ग्रेट नोइंग दैट बजाज कैपिटल इज नाउ यू नो इन्वॉल्विंग विद इट्स स्टेक होल्डर्स होलिस्टिकली Because normally I'll tell you, businesses cannot sustain unless the stakeholders, all stakeholders sustain. The conventional style of entrepreneurship in India often has been that, you know, meetha bolo kam tolo. And India being a family business, there were only stakeholders in the family. Neither the investors, nor the buyers, nor the general public. We as a country have never cared for anyone.
Right.
So it is heartening to note that, you know, in fact, I'm a big fan of Rahul Bajaj. And he has, in fact, that is a different family, of course. But yes, Rahul Bajaj and his father, Jamnalal Bajaj, whom Mahatma Gandhi used to call his fifth son. In fact, the Bajaj Group has its own contribution to the, in fact, both the brothers. And the way they have contributed to the nation is a lesson. And if you look at the business history, the way India grew up is basically not about the Britishers. It's not about the freedom fight. It's about the handful of entrepreneurs. Whether you take the Birlas, whether you take the Tatas, whether you take the Bajaj, whether you take Kasturbai Lal Bhai, whether you take the modern day Azim Premjis and Narayan Murthys. So these are the people who had a sense of purpose. These are the people who built actually their companies around all these pillars. You know,
right, sir. I would just like to make one small correction here, sir. Sorry to interrupt you. And for everybody who is a part of this audience here today. Sir, we are not connected with Mr. Rahul Bajaj family.
No, I know, sir. The brothers.
Any manner.
Not even brothers.
Not even. We are not related to them in any manner whatsoever. Apart from that, also our clients are only in financial services industry.
So this is completely separated businesses.
Completely separated. No relationship whatsoever. Our motto. You know what? Our senior chairman, Mr. K.K. Bajaj, Kuldeep Kumar Bajaj, who started the company, taught us. That treat your client as your own retired father and give him that advice which you will give to your own father. So this is his mantra which we are following for last 55 years. And now from financial well-being, we move to total well-being. So not only we take care of the money aspects, but whatever research we have done, we'd like to share it in terms of the 10 pillars of Omni Life.
Because my only idea is that if we are not compassionate enough by running a company, you know, if you're not compassionate, the business won't run. Why? what happens, you will see after COVID, the entire business streams would change. The way you do business will change. We have seen banking change in last 20 years, 30 years, you know, when the ATMs came, now when RTGS and, you know, electronic transmission of money has happened. So I simply feel that businesses would change.
Right.
You probably, Bajaj Capital may move to another type of a business, right? Related to, you know, yes, but you know, compassion is the key to survival. And, you know, since our lifestyles will change, we'll have a different way of living. And probably you will have to make a living, you have to create a different business model. And this is actually, I'll tell you what happens in other countries. Some of the countries who have survived, the reason I was saying stakeholders, say Korea, South Korea, say Japan, say Germany, they have their employees as key stakeholders.
Yes.
So somewhere I think the idea of, you know, the large business families, the way we worked in India, the large, you know, these 10 pillars are the only way you can actually move ahead. Otherwise, if the consumers or investors don't survive, nobody would. As I said in the beginning, with PMI going to 5, that would mean you would take now people, it will be very hard for you to make people invest. They'll say, no, I'll only save. I'll not invest. People will become more risk averse. Probably our equity markets will completely die out. Because already our equity markets are not run by common investors. There are barely 4 crore DMAT accounts in this country. Remaining approximately 8.5 crore mutual fund folios, right? NBFCs are facing a very difficult times in terms of liquidity only because the investor is now a little worried. He's saying, I don't want to part with my money, give it to you and you run away. We have just had Punjab Maharashtra Mercantile Bank falling. Then we had another bank falling, and today Yes Bank has shown 3,000 crore losses, 3,300 crore losses. So whether it is banking or non-banking systems, those who will care for their investors will survive. So I think, you know, as a business school, I feel happy that you joined us and gave us this wonderful talk. It made everybody introspect. I was very happy that most of my colleagues were actually writing throughout, and they were trying to pick up points. Probably they'll pick up these points and discuss with the students and develop some original ideas into bigger ideas. And because teachers, their job is to disseminate information. Their job is to disseminate, of course, convert information to knowledge and then disseminate it. What we feel is that this will become a turning point for many. And as you suggested, that health and well-being, they are largely dependent upon how we feel. So I'd rather give you a 2,500 years ago quotation by a Roman philosopher, Greek philosopher Epictetus. And he always said, what happens to us is not dependent on the events around us, but how we react to them.
Right.
So whatever we do, I think it's our reactions to events which matters. As human beings, we have long memories. I request, in fact, a lot of my colleagues have read Yuval Noah Harari. His book, Homo Sapiens. We are here for millions of years, probably will be there millions of years. But I think one of the most important thing is now, whatever we have, how do we sustain it? Right. How do we ensure that our next generations remain alive? So one thing, I think being a little less selfish also makes one healthy. Compassionate, being a little less greedy also makes it a little more healthy. So thank you very much, sir. And our alumnus also, where is he gone? I think Amit.
Amit is there.
I can see him here. And please pass on this as a WhatsApp message, Bajaj Capital's 10 pillars. And please pass on a brief bio of Chopra sahab also. We would love to have him again. I'm not a believer of viruses. Viruses keep mutating, but we can't stop living. Viruses will come and go. Even if you create a vaccine, this is not going to go away. So we are very keen that the normal life would start. Whatever the new normal will be, we'll take precautions and probably things will normalize at a different level and lifestyles would change. But yes, I'm not too afraid of this virus. But we do hope that we'll see both Amit and Chopra sahab at our campus and interacting with the students and faculty members in person. Thank you very much, sir.
Right. Okay. Thank you. Before you wind up, sir, I would request Professor Anita Singh to propose the vote of thanks. Madam, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Sure, I'm here.
Yes, madam, please.
It's my pleasure to extend a vote of thanks towards the end of this such an interactive sessions by Mr. Anil Chopra, Director of Bajaj Auto Limited, and our very own media alumnus, Mr. Amit Cook Chauhan, for taking time from their busy schedule and sharing with us such a wonderful session on holistic approach for total well-being. Thank you, sir, for taking such an interactive session with our faculty and student and making us aware about the 10 pillars of well-being. A very apt session in this COVID environment where it is very difficult to maintain a disciplined life. And I'm grateful to our dynamic leader and a man abiding 10 pillars of life, our director, Professor Alok Pandey, for his continuous mentoring and guidance. We cannot think of organizing any event without the presence and support of Mr. Dr. Tapan Kumar Nair, our Dean Academics. So I'm thankful for him, to him for his continuous support. Extend my special thanks to our faculty colleague, staff members, students for being such a wonderful audience and making the, for me, and also they, I'm thankful to them for making this event a very lively and interactive one. So thank you all for being here, and it was such a nice session for all of us. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
And there's a wonderful way of generating a feedback also, sir. I think this is
yes.
A nice poll which is coming. I think wonderful, sir. This is great. And it is great that this COVID has made all of us recognize a one more medium to interact. And what we are doing now at our institute is 25% of all courses, or probably 25% of total courses, we will now make online.
Right.
We will ensure that regular webinars keep happening, and we don't forget this idea, because we've used all possible methods. We've used Google Meet, Microsoft Teams. We have used this Zoom, which is now a professional version which we are using. And we probably try to buy annual basis for the institute something. Sure. We are trying all the... So we hope to see you once again, sir. Right. Thank you very much.
For sure. All of you have a nice day.
आपने सब चार्ट सेट कर लिए, मैं आपको डिटेल्स भेज दूंगा. आप ये जो रिकॉर्डिंग किए हैं आप मुझे मेरे मेल आईडी में और अनिता मैडम को भेज दीजिएगा. Right. Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
So I'm stopping the session now. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.